Now that we can receive the position of our physics object in the world, we have to figure out how to set the position of a physics body, which, in contrast, is a little bit trickier. Scrolling through the documentation, you'll most likely see a nice API called setPosition, which will do exactly what you think and set the position of the physics body in the world, regardless of how physics are acting upon it. Note that this type of teleportation will ignore any types of collision that may occur before the position is set. In other words, setPosition teleports you to the desired position first, and then calculates the physics response. As such, you should only use setPosition when you're intentionally trying to teleport and when you know where you're going. Imagine how Nightcrawler feels. So in order to get moving with this, the first thing we need to do is once the physics body's been created, we can actually call the setLinearVelocity function on the physics body, setting its initial velocity vector so that this body can be simulated and updated properly. And if you recall, we remove the velocity from objects each frame in order to keep them from sliding around our world like hockey pucks. As such, any objects that want continuous movement, say, for instance, a rocket moving at a constant speed, need to set the linear velocity of the physics body each frame to ensure it's moving. We see a perfect example of this in the simple projectile class, which will set the linear velocity before sampling from the physics body.